Hey guys, Caleb Thornton here, coming back with a shorter video today. And today we're gonna be taking a look at a mouse bungee, and this is their second iteration or their V2 of the Razer mouse bungee. But besides just talking about this one, the build quality and what this one has to offer, we're also gonna just talk about what are the benefits of a mouse bungee and is it something that you're even gonna want or need? First off, let's just touch on the fact of what is this for and would you even benefit from it? Overall, the main principle of it is just to try to remove any variables that could affect your in-game performance or your aim. So obviously by kind of reducing or getting rid of your cable, basically altogether, almost creating that wireless feel for it, it's gonna give you that more potential for having consistent mouse movements and therefore improving your aim. It basically just provides you an anchor point or a fixed point for your cable to be on, which is gonna reduce or completely get rid of cable getting tangled up, getting stuck on things, causing extra drag for you. So basically it's just giving you that clean slate, removing variables that could possibly affecting your in-game performance or aim. Looking at the Razer Mouse Bungee V2 itself, I mean, it's just a simple design, and obviously that's just because it serves a simple purpose overall. It is nice quality though, it feels premium in hand. You get this plastic bottom shell, which is weighted, and then you also have a rubber base on it, which is just gonna be there to help you from it moving around on your desk itself. As far as the springs go, nice quality, and those are obviously there to give you a little bit more give if you were to pull into the springs, because it will move with you rather than just being a completely fixed anchor point. Then you also do get some more cable management, like clips or things you can run your cable in down the back if you want a cable management even more. As far as like cord acceptability, I guess you could say, or what it will accept, it's gonna accept basically any mouse cable you can find to put in here, just because of the fact that it is rubber. You're gonna be able to open it up to any size on this back and fit any cable in. So far with all the mice I've tested on it, no issues as far as that cable fitting in. The setup for your mouse bungee itself is super simple. You're just gonna wanna take it, and then wherever your playing surface is at, where you're using your mouse or your mouse pad most likely, is you're just gonna set it right behind it. Usually right behind it, but maybe depending on your setup, you might wanna have it a little bit farther back to get that cable back even farther. And then you're just gonna wanna route your cable into the top of it, which you can either do just by pushing it right in, or you can kinda slide it into place. And then obviously if you want to, you have those extra clips back there to route it into as well. And then you're gonna wanna see where you're gonna playing at as far as swiping, you know, right to left. So wherever you'll be reaching to, reach that point, make sure you have enough slack to reach those, but also not too much where you're gonna be going off, and not too little where when you reach it, you're pulling on these springs, which is really gonna mess up with your aim. So once you have that dialed in, you're all set to go, and you should be getting rid of any extra cable drag that you might get without the bungee. At first, when hearing about mouse bungees, I mean, they definitely did kind of seem gimmicky to me, and maybe you feel that same way. I mean, it just seems weird having something on your desk where you're gonna be sticking your mouse cable up into. But I have to say, after a couple of months of using it, I can definitely see the benefit of it and the big appeal of why someone would want to use it. Obviously, probably as you get to the worst side of cables, like rubber cables or thicker cables that aren't as flexible, you're probably gonna get a bigger benefit from it. But even using a high quality paracord in this, I mean, it gives you the closest to possible wireless mouse feel while still having a wired mouse. So overall, I definitely think there's a market for this, and I definitely think there's a good reason why they exist. So if you guys are thinking about it, obviously it's gonna depend from person to person, maybe how serious you are with gaming, or if it's even something that you've ever even thought of using. But I definitely see the reason for it. And if you're someone that wants to try to eliminate that drag, giving you the best potential for consistent aim as well as consistent mouse movements, then this is definitely gonna offer that to you. As far as the Razer Mouse Bungee V2 itself, I think it's a high quality one, although I have not tested out others, but in comparisons or reviews I've seen of them as well, I definitely would say this is definitely a contender for a great one, coming in at around $20. So, you know, it's not breaking the bank by any means, and they're all hovering around that same price point. So overall, a mouse bungee in general, as well as the Razer Mouse Bungee V2, is gonna be a recommendation from me. Thank you guys so much for watching the video, and if you found it helpful or informative, please hit that like button for me, and do consider subscribing for more content just like this coming up in the very near future. If you guys have any questions about the mouse bungee or just my time using it, maybe some of the benefits of it, definitely let me know in the comments down below, and I'll try my best to get back to you quickly and also with the best response I can. I'll see you guys in the next one.